Well, U.S. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi says that her caucus has decided it can no longer wait for Senator Joe Manchin to agree with every provision in their multi-trillion dollar Build Back Better bill. So inaction is no longer an option. Capitol Hill correspondent Erik Rosales has the latest.
Sources tell me in a closed-door meeting, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi told fellow Democrats that she wants a vote on President Biden's economic agenda bill tonight and then hold a vote on the bipartisan infrastructure bill Friday morning.
We're going to pass both bills, but in order to do so, we have to have votes for both bills, and that's where we are.
Negotiations between moderates and progressive Democrats continue. They've added back a paid family leave program to the bill, plus a measure sharply raising the $10,000 cap on state and local tax deductions. But it will face challenges in the Senate. Senator Joe Manchin has objected to include paid family leave.
When there's participation between the employer and the employee, from the small companies, small businesses that I represent all over West Virginia and all over the country, but basically it should be participation. We can do that in a bipartisan way.
Moderates are also publicly worried about immigration-related provisions. Progressive Democrats still want assurances from the Senate that the bill will survive the chamber intact, and those assurances are impossible to give. Republicans continue to tell me the president's agenda is too expensive.
A bill that I think is a fraud, that's going to be a pouring gasoline on inflation problems we have in the country, and the reconciliation bill in the House rewards special interest at the expense of the public at large.
House Democrats were planning to go on recess next week, but that could be put on hold to get these bills passed. At the Capitol, Erik Rosales, EWTN News Nightly.